This video, I'll discuss the application of derivatives in finding the points of local maxima and local minima. So first we will see the meaning of local maxima and local maximum value. Let f be a real valued function and let c be an interior point in the domain of f. Then C is called the point of local maxima if there is an h greater than 0 such that f of c greater than or equal to f of x for all x in the open interval c minus h, comma c plus h. The value f of c is called the local maximum value of f. So we have a real valued function f and c is any point in the domain of f. We call this point C a point of local maxima if there is another interval, say C minus H, comma C plus H, and in this interval f of C is greater than or equal to f of X for all X in this interval. And the value f of C is called the local maximum value of F. Now we'll see with the help of a diagram, we'll understand what is local maxima and local minima. So here if we see, here all these points are local maxima. So here we can see that all these points are points of local maxima. If we consider a small interval h, say this is c and here we have c minus h and here we have c plus h. Here among these points we can see that this is the maximum value for f of x. This is given by f of c. Now let us take another point, say c1, and here let us consider an interval c1 minus h2, c1 plus h. So here among these points we can see that f of c1 is greater than all the other values for x belong to c1 minus h, comma c1 plus h. Here if we consider this point say c2, then here this is a point of local maxima and f of c2 is the local maximum value. Now similar to the points of local maxima, all these are points of maxima and these are the maximum values of the function. Similar to points of local maxima, we have points of local minima. So here if we see, here these two points are points of local minima and these are the corresponding local minimum values. So now we will see what is local minima. C is called a point of local minima if there is an h greater than 0 such that f of c less than or equal to f of x for all x in the open interval c minus h, comma c plus h. The value f of c is called the local minimum value of f. So we have seen local maxima, local minima and the local maximum value and the local minimum value of f. Now we will see how derivatives can be used in finding the local maxima and local minima. So here if we consider say this point C, here we can see that it is a turning point or a critical point. So here f dash of C is equal to 0. And if we consider in the close neighborhood of C, if we consider the curve, in this side we can see that f dash of X is, it is greater than 0, and on the other side we can see that f dash of x is less than 0. Here it means Here it means to the left of the critical point, we can see that the function is increasing, and to the right of the critical point, we can see that the function is decreasing. So in this case, we can say that this point is the point of local maxima. So this point is called the point of local maxima. Now coming to local minima. So here we can, if we consider this point, say C dash, and if we consider the curve to the left of C dash, we can see that the function is strictly decreasing, or f dash of x less than 0, and to the right of the point, we can see that f dash of x is greater than 0. So if we have f dash of x less than 0, to the left of the critical point, and f dash of x greater than 0 to the right of the critical point, then we call this point as the point of local minima. So this is the point of local minima, and this is the point of local maxima. And these are the corresponding local maximum values and the local minimum values. Now we will see what first derivative test says. Let f be a function defined on an open interval D. Let f be continuous at a critical point C in D. Then if f dash of x changes sign from positive to negative as x increases through C, that is, if f dash of x greater than 0 at every point sufficiently close to and to the left of C, and f dash of x less than 0 at every point sufficiently close to and to the right of C, then C is a point of local maxima. So as I just now said, if to the left of C, if f dash of x is greater than 0, and to the right of C, if f dash of x is less than 0, then we call this point C as a point of local maxima. Now similarly for local minima, if f dash of x changes sign from negative to positive as x increases through C, that is, if f dash of x less than 0 at every point sufficiently close to and to the left of C, and f dash of x greater than 0 at every point sufficiently close to and to the right of C, then C is a point of local minima. So this is what was explained with the help of the graph. So these are points of local maxima and local minima. This is how we can use first derivative to find the points of local maxima and local minima. Now, if f dash of x does not change the sign as x increases through C, then C is neither a point of local maxima nor a point of local minima, and such a point is called a point of inflection. So the method to find the point of inflection we'll see later. So this is how the first derivative test is useful in finding whether a point is a point of local minima or a point of local maxima when those points are critical points. Now we will see the second derivative test. Now this is commonly used to find the point of local maxima and local minima. Let f be a function defined on an open interval D. Let f be continuous at a critical point C in D. Let f be twice differentiable at C. F be twice differentiable means we are able to find f dash of x at C and f double dash of x at C. That is the second derivative of x at C. X is equal to C is a point of local maxima if f dash of C equal to 0 and f double dash of C is less than 0. So here we call a point C a point of local maxima if this condition is satisfied. F dash of C equal to 0 and f double dash of C less than 0. the value f of c is the local maximum value of f. Similarly, x is equal to c is a point of local minima if f dash of c equal to 0 and f double dash of c is greater than 0. In this case, f of c is the local minimum value of f. We say the test fails if f dash of c equal to 0 and f double dash of c is also equal to 0. Here, if this situation occurs, either we have to go to the next type of method of finding the local maxima or local minima, or we have to use the first derivative test. Now we will see what are points of inflection. So here, when we consider this curve, if we take this point P, this point is called a point of inflection, and similarly in this curve, this point P is called a point of inflection. It means if we draw a tangent at this point P, then some part of the curve lies below the tangent and some part of the curve lies above the tangent. Similarly, here also we can see that some part of the curve lies above the tangent and the remaining part lies below the tangent at this point. So these points are called points of inflection. So here at points of inflection, we have f dash of x equal to 0, f double dash of x also equal to 0, and next derivative, it is not equal to 0. That is, the third order derivative is not equal to 0. We call a point C a point of inflection if f dash of C equal to 0 and f double dash of C equal to 0. But if we take the derivative of this, f triple dash of C is not equal to 0. Now, why this point of inflection is of importance? Because when we have f dash of c equal to 0, then we will consider c as a critical point or a turning point, and we will try to find f double dash of c to find the point of local maxima and local minima. If this is also equal to 0, then the next step is we have to find the derivative of this f double dash of x and substitute c equal to 0. Then we say this point c is a point of inflection, and the given function does not have any local maxima or local minima. So this is the use of finding the point of inflection. So here are the exercise questions from exercise 6.4 of chapter 6, application of derivatives, from the book Applied Mathematics, class 12, by M.L. Agarwal. So the first question is, find the turning points of the following functions and distinguish between them. Also find the local maximum and the local minimum values of the function. So here we have to find the turning points. Turning points are nothing but the critical points of the given functions, and we have to distinguish them. Distinguish them means we have to say whether those points are points of maxima or points of minima. Also find the local maximum and the local minimum values of the function. So the first one is f of x is equal to 2x cubed minus 21x square plus 36x minus 20. So first let us find f dash of x. F dash of x is equal to 6x square minus 42x plus 36. This is equal to 6 into x square minus 7x plus 6. Now we know that at the critical points f dash of x equal to 0, which means 6 into x square minus 7x plus 6 equal to 0. Or this is a quadratic equation in x. So we can solve for x. So we can write this as x minus 1 into x minus 6 equal to 0. So the roots of this quadratic equation are x is equal to 1 comma 6. Now we will find f double dash of x. So to find the local maxima or local minima, we need to have f dash of c equal to 0 and f double dash of c less than 0 means it is a point of local maxima. If f double dash of c greater than 0 means it is a point of local minima. So f double dash of x is, so from here we can find f double dash of x. It is 12x minus 42. So we have two critical points, x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 6. So let me continue here. So we got f double dash of x as 12x minus 42 and x is equal to 1 comma 6 are the critical points. So at x is equal to 1, we have f double dash of 1 is equal to 12 minus 42 equal to minus 30, which is less than 0. Therefore, x is equal to 1 is a point of local maxima. And the local maximum value is given by value of f of x is nothing but f of 1. So when we substitute 1 x as 1 in f of x, we get 2 minus 21 plus 36 minus 20, or it is equal to minus 3. So the point of local maxima is 1 and the local maximum value is minus 3. Now the next point, at x is equal to 6, f double dash of 6 is equal to 12 into 6 minus 42. It is 72 minus 42, positive 30. It is greater than 0. Therefore, x is equal to 6 is a point of local minima. So we have to be careful. If f double dash of x is less than 0, it is a point of local maxima. If f double dash of x is greater than 0, it is a point of local minima. And the local minimum value is equal to f of 6. So it is equal to 2 into 6 cube minus 21 into 6 square plus 36 into 6 minus 20. So the answer is minus 128. So we can write the points. Therefore, 1 comma minus 3. So here x is equal to, when x is equal to 1, we get f of x is equal to, it is minus 3. So the point 1 comma minus 3 is the point of local maxima, and the point 6 comma minus 128 is the point of local minima. And 6 comma minus 128 is the point of local minima. Next question, f of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 3x. So first let us find that stationary points or the critical points or turning points. So for that we have to find f dash of x. So f dash of x is equal to 3x square minus 6x plus 3. Or it is equal to 3 into x square minus 2x plus 1. So we know that at the critical points f dash of x equal to 0. It means x square minus 2x plus 1 equal to 0. This is nothing but x minus 1 the whole square. So we get x is equal to 1 as a critical point. Now we will find f double dash of x. So from here f double dash of x is 6x minus or 6 into x minus 1. So at x is equal to 1, we can see that f double dash of x is 6 into 1 minus 1, 0. So here the second derivative test fails. That is, we cannot see whether x is a point of maxima or minima. Now we'll check whether x is equal to 1 is a point of inflection. Now, f triple dash of x, it is nothing but you have to differentiate f double dash of x with respect to x. So, when we differentiate this with respect to x, we get f triple dash of x is equal to 6. This is not equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to 1. This is a point of inflection. Therefore, f of x has no local maxima or minima. Next question. Find the coordinates of stationary points on the curve y is equal to x cube minus 3x square minus 9x plus 7 and distinguish between points of local maxima and local minima. So it is similar to the previous question. Here we have to find the coordinates of stationary points and we have to find whether those points are points of local maxima or points of local minima. So here we have y is equal to x cube minus 3x square minus 9x plus 7. Now let us differentiate with respect to x. I'm writing it as y dash. Y dash is nothing but dy by dx. It is equal to 3x square minus 6x minus 9. Or it is equal to 3 into x square minus 2x minus 3. So we know that at critical points y dash equal to 0, it means 3 into x square minus 2x minus 3 equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation in x and the roots are minus 3 and plus 1. So it is x minus 3 into x plus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to minus 1 comma 3. Now we will find y double dash. Now y double dash is, we have to differentiate y dash with respect to x. So it is 6x minus 6. Okay. Now at x is equal to minus 1, we have y double dash is equal to minus 6 minus 6 equal to minus 12. It is less than 0. Therefore, x is equal to minus 1 is a point of local maxima. And the local maximum value is, we continue here. y of minus 1 equal to minus 1 the whole cube minus 3 into minus 1 square minus 9 into minus 1 plus 7. Or it is equal to 12. Therefore, minus 1 comma 12 is a point of local maxima. Now we have another critical point, x is equal to 3. At x is equal to 3, we have y double dash is equal to 6 into 3 minus 6, or it is 18 minus 6, which is 12, greater than 0. Therefore, x is equal to 3 is a point of local minima. So at x is equal to 3, y is equal to 3 cube minus 3 into 3 square minus 9 into 3 plus 7, or it is equal to minus 20. Therefore, 3 comma minus 20 is the point of local minima. I hope this video was useful for you. In my next video, I'll continue with the exercise questions. Thank you for watching.